Sunday, 7:45, Inspector Morse.
What I think happened was that Foster found out that his wife was having an affair with Anthony John, killed him, told her, and got his comeuppance this afternoon.
From his own wife?
She's in shock, but that's my guess.
What about Lewis's back on the head?
If we'd found them first, it would have been obvious.
A deadly deception for Inspector Morse, Sunday.
Thank you. Here on Thames Television in just over 7 minutes, we join the studios of ITN for the day's national and international news. Now the time is 10 o'clock. There now follows a party political broadcast by the Labour Party.
A millionaire living in a mansion pays less in poll tax than a low-income family in a small house. No other modern democracy has ever introduced a tax that takes no account of ability to pay.
The poll tax is a very unfair tax.
Everybody pays the same tax. Whatever you earn is basically unfair.
Any system of raising taxation has got to be based on a person's ability to pay. I don't think it can be any other way.
The government's poll tax calculations were based on 4% inflation. Inflation is double that and rising. What's more, insufficient allowance was made for the sheer cost of collecting a tax from every adult in the country.
It's totally incompetent insofar as it's going to cost so much to implement the whole thing.
I think it's going to be a very costly tax to collect, and that's going to rebound on people like us who have to pay it. We'll end up paying for it twice over.
It's definitely a government initiative. It's come from the centre rather than locally. And local government in trying to implement the poll tax are the people who are complaining just as much as anybody else because they can't see how it can work.
The government claims Labour councils are to blame for high poll tax bills, but average poll tax levels from Tory councils are almost exactly the same.
My wife and I paying our poll tax, it's slightly more than our rates, but that's just for this year. Next year, who knows? I think it will be significantly more next year.
Well, I think it's shown up the government for what they've really been up to over the last few years.
The poll tax has divided the Tories. Tory councillors have resigned en masse, and even a cabinet minister has threatened to go.
The government are certainly suffering a loss of credibility at the moment, not only from the man in the street, but also from their supporters, and perhaps worst of all, from people who are occupying positions of authority within the Conservative Party.
Staunch Conservative supporters seem to be very anti-poll tax.
My grandmother, who has always voted Tory, now hates them, so.
Most people will lose as a result of the poll tax, but even those who gain are rejecting the government's appeal to selfishness and greed.
The high-income rate people will benefit from it all.
Why should I pay less when I can afford it, and those that can least afford it have to pay more?
Most of the extra money we pay in poll tax won't provide extra services. Instead, it will fuel inflation in an economy that already has the worst inflation in Europe.
A number of people, whatever the party, are definitely going against the government on this one, especially as we've seen a number of economic problems which are reducing people's ability to pay the poll tax.
The primary objectives of the local authority will suffer badly. We won't get the same services we do presently.
Thousands of families managing on low incomes and struggling under the burden of higher prices and mortgages will be pushed into even deeper debt by the poll tax.
I'm a student nurse, and student nurses are not actually classified as students, and therefore I have to pay, and I'm on a very low income.
The people who are struggling to make ends meet are the ones that are going to find it difficult.
I think people aren't going to be able to afford to pay it in a lot of cases.
I'm going to be paying nearly 10% of my wages.
It is not, therefore, a tax for an incoming government to amend. It is not a tax to improve. The poll tax is a tax to abolish, and that is what we should do with the poll tax. We shall replace it with a system of taxes and rebates in which tax is calculated on property and charged according to ability to pay.
I voted Tory the last time.
I did vote Conservative, but I will not vote Conservative again.
I don't feel particularly happy with the party that I voted for last time.
I voted Conservative in the last general election. I've learned from that. I definitely know now, I was wrong.
My grandmother, who's always voted Tory, is going to change her mind on that big issue. Then, Thatcher had better watch out. She's going to lose.
I'll definitely say I'm going to vote Labour in this election.
Join the 01200 0200, or write to Free Post, London SE17 1BR.
That was a party political broadcast by the Labour Party.
We've top-class boxing and international football on midweek sports special tonight. European featherweight champion Paul Hodgkinson knows victory against Eduardo Montoya guarantees a shot at the world title. With the finals just 72 days away, Scotland's World Cup countdown begins against the best, Argentina, at Hampden Park. And the Republic of Ireland, poised for their first ever World Cup, warm up against Wales in Dublin. All the day's news as well, midweek sports special after news at 10.
This is Thames Television. Now we catch up with the day's national and international news from ITN with Alistair Burnett and Trevor MacDonald.
Caught at Heathrow, devices to trigger a nuclear bomb. Five arrested trying to smuggle them to Iraq. Actors reconstruct the Birmingham bombing. Television names names. South Africa has to live with growing violence again. And Mr. Ridley says you've heard all you're hearing about Harrods. Good evening. 40 nuclear bomb triggers bound for Iraq have been seized at Heathrow Airport after a joint operation between British and American investigators. The devices were waiting to be loaded on an Iraqi Airways jet bound for Baghdad. Two men were arrested at the airport and three others in London and Surrey. One Iraqi has been deported. The others include a woman and a man born in Iraq and a Lebanese. American customs discovered the plan last year. It's believed that the bomb triggers were bought in San Diego, California, and investigators followed the trail through to today's arrests at Heathrow.
The operation at Heathrow Airport was carried out...